the market regulator's action. It approved new rules for portfolio managers on Wednesday. SEBI's also cut the time frame for rights issues drastically. And what's also taken some by surprise is the regulator's mandate that listed entities have to declare any default within 31 days of doing so. Sajit Mangan is here to tell us more about it. I thought, Sajit, that that was anyways in the works, so it might not be a big surprise, but now they reaffirm the 31 days. But beyond that, or 30 days plus 24 hours, but beyond that, a clutch of other moves.
Yeah, that's right. If you look at the rights issue thing, 31 days was something expected because the working group also recommended. And SEBI also has this window of reducing it by further 7 days or so because the Companies Act requires 14 days of issuance period for any rights issue. So if that gets amended, then SEBI has much more leeway to bring it down further. So, you know, as of now, it's T plus 31. Once approval comes in from the regulator, and then 31 days, so it can come down to as small as 3 weeks. That's what the regulator said. But the bigger thing is the allowing rights entitlement to be traded on the stock exchanges, because currently what we see is there's an off-market trading that happens for rights entitlement. Now that will be brought in on the platform of stock exchanges. Now it would also mean that better pricing of rights, and also for minority investors who are now, you know, not participating in the rights, at least now be able to sell it on the exchange and get some money off it. So it's a very good move in, you know, expanding the product profile which is available on the stock exchange platform there. The other thing is the portfolio managers regulations. There have been huge changes there, especially with respect to starting from the net worth being increased to 2 to 5 years, but they've been given 3 years to meet that net worth. But the bigger one would be the threshold being increased to 50 lakhs. Now, that would mean that anyone now going for a new investment into the portfolio manager will have to ensure that he puts a minimum of 50 lakhs, or if he's already one, then any top up should ensure that it goes above 50 lakhs. So it's not a 5-5 increment about 25, which normally people used to do. If you have 25 lakhs, then you have to bring in another 25 lakhs. Otherwise, otherwise it gets grandfathered at what it is at this point in time.
No, so sorry. So you're saying existing people who have got an investment of 25 lakh rupees, that doesn't get disturbed?
That doesn't get disturbed.
New investments.
But if they're going to do a top up, it has to be 25 lakhs. It cannot be 5 lakhs.
It can't be 5 lakhs. Lakhs.
Okay. So they have to go beyond the 50 lakh threshold to ensure that, you know, they meet the SEBI regulation there. So that has been grandfathered, but the bigger one would be capping of operational expenses at 4.5%, which is part of the working group. But you know, it will bring in much more structure and some more restrictions for the portfolio managers, you know, especially with respect to disclosures, with respect to returns. Now, what was happening is that the brochure had some return, the regulator was getting some return, and on a monthly or periodic basis, clients were getting some other return. That has been streamlined, and now they will have to have a common profile or you know, standard format for those returns based on time-weighted rate of return, which they will be providing there. Bigger thing, direct window for portfolio managers. You know, currently, if you speak to the industry, at least 80% of them come through distributors. And a distribution fee is a very high fee because they take upfront fees, and that entire upfront fee goes as distribution fee for many portfolio managers. Now they are allowing a direct window for PMs. Should have a direct window of their own, so that, you know, there is no distribution fee which is comes in. So advisory fees comes in, but distribution fee may be hit for many of them.
Right.
And the distributors will have to be certified by a SEBI registered course and be part of the MFI registration. So all those restrictions are bringing in tighter. And the next step would be the alternate investment funds, because the working group is now working on that to bring in more transparency there, because there isn't much. And finally, the default part of it. For listed debt securities continues to be 2 days, but for default with a financial institution like a bank, they've given 30 days to, you know, notify. So while some would say that it's a relaxation from 2 to 30 days, but banks never had that 30-day period or any period of disclosure. So this becomes some bit of, you know, regulatory hurdle for many of the entities who were not earlier disclosing it to the exchanges or to the shareholders.
But it's great for shareholders. I don't know if bank provisioning moves up as a result of this on a quarter-on-quarter basis. I think that's
well, the key. So the reason why it was not been done, because there was no tri-party agreement between this credit rating agency, the bank and the client. Because it was confidential information between bank and client, credit rating agencies never used to get this information. Now they will be given this information at the end of 30 days if there is a default.